Hello guys, this is a BMW 7 Series and also my third Motovlog. In today's Motovlog, we will be talking about the costs and if you should have a bike or a motorcycle in London. If you are a motorcycle lover and you know everything about motorcycles, then the question, is it worth it? It's not for you. For us, it is always worth it. Doesn't matter how much you pay. We love these things. We love these two-wheeled things with a good engine in the middle. So the price and costs to it is just... doesn't matter. It just does not matter at all. But for other people that might be thinking to start biking or to buy their own bike, or if you're just curious about how much it costs to actually own a bike in London, I'm gonna reveal everything to you. So let's start with the costs. Let's start with the official cost of actually owning a motorcycle in London. So it is relatively easy to buy a motorcycle in London, mostly due to the fact that motorcycles are not that expensive and salaries are high, per se. Your average motorcycle, when bought new, like a Hornet, for example, if they still existed, but right now you have the CB650F. Your CB650F will cost you roughly 6,500 pounds, roughly. Might be a bit wrong, might be around 7,000, but the value will be around that. So the cost of the bike itself is not too high, bearing in mind that the average salary within London is about 1,200 pounds, maybe a bit more. So this initial cost, if there's something that you like and if it's something that you want to do, it's not very high. Alright, so you got your bike now. What do you need? You need insurance. Let's talk about the biggest ripoff we have here in the UK. This is where it hurts in the pocket. Insurances are often quite expensive in London. And not just for motorcycles, but also for cars. They tend to become really, really, really expensive. So, for example, on my Hornet, we're talking about a 2012 Hornet. So this is a 5-year-old bike. Never had any accidents, never had any claims. I have my license now for 5 years. So basically, since I bought the bike, I've got my license for 5 years now. And a third-party theft and fire insurance is costing me £800 a year. This hurts in the pocket because those £800 could be going somewhere a lot better than a measly insurance company. But there's not much I can do about it. I need insurance, and to remain fully legal, I need to pay for it. So there's a high cost of insurance around here. What about, let's say, insurance is there and it's always going to be around those values. Imagine if you're getting a super sports or super bike, whatever you want to call it. Then your insurance will very likely be over that. I know people with more years of license than me, and they're paying more insurance because their bikes are quite expensive, and they're paying a little fortune every year just to get their bikes insured. And the thing is, if you get third party, insurance drops rapidly. I mean, you can probably insure the same for the same price that I was insuring it in Portugal. Thing is, in Portugal there's no fear of bike theft. Bikes are not the new CBR. She's already on the streets, boys. You can go for third party insurance only and it will be very cheap. But the way things are going in London at the moment, I wouldn't risk it. I wouldn't risk getting third party only and then getting your bike stolen and there's nothing you can do. You just get empty-handed and your investment is just gone. Too much traffic today. Can't actually ride around and talk too much because Every little distraction will get us hit by a car. Or we will hit a car. So, since we're stopped here for a little bit, so bikes are quite inexpensive, bearing in mind the salary that you're getting. Insurance is quite expensive. It will probably be one of your salaries, a whole month's salary into insurance. There is road tax that you need to pay every year. It's also a very low amount. It's about £60, if I'm not wrong. That's what I pay for the Hornet. What the hell, man? Really? What the hell was that, man? Fully red light. One very important question here, or one very important piece of information is, how much does fuel cost? Well, when comparing to our salaries, fuel is extremely, extremely cheap around here. So that's something that I don't think it will influence too much on the idea or on the opinion if you should buy a bike or not. Petrol here will cost you about 120 per liter. I've seen it at £1 2 years ago, before this whole Brexit thing and this and that. But it will average. It will average at about 120 per liter. So to compare to you guys and to show you guys how different and how easy it is, in Portugal petrol costs €1.50 and your minimum salary is €500. How ridiculous is that? Your salary is lower, your petrol is more expensive, so you end up counting all the money that you have and how much your bike is consuming so that you can actually afford it. Here, not too much. I just fill it up whenever it needs to be refilled. I refill it and that's it. Don't actually count it. What other costs are there when riding a motorcycle? Gear. You obviously need gear. So helmet is mandatory. All the rest you can ride butt naked. It's up to you if you want to lose little bit of skin in case you crash or not. But if you want to gear up, and I'm not saying buy the best of the best of the best of the best that you can, if you want to minimally gear up and be ready for the rain, then you'll need another £1,000. We're talking about buying Gore-Tex equipment, Gore-Tex stuff, so that you're ready for every occasion. Sorry about all this squeaking in my wheel. I think there's my wheel bearings. There's some issue with it. First I thought it was the discs. Now I think it's the wheel bearing because it gets worse with time. So I think when it starts to heat up, it gets more friction and it messes it up more. Another thing you need to think about, again, due to the current situation in London, is security. So, a good chain will set you back £150, if not £250, if you're gonna go hardcore. A good disc lock will set you back £90. And a tracker will set you back £400 immediately, and then a further, I think, £10 a month, I think. I'm not so sure of that. So let's go back and review everything. Insurance, £800 a year. Fire, theft, and third party. Road tax, £60 a year for a 600. Maintenance, this includes kind of mandatory oil change per year between other bits and bobs. Count on £150 to whatever, it depends what breaks down, but count, let's say £150 a year. Plus, if you ride a lot, count on two more tires on that, that's another £200. gear, helmet, anywhere from 100 to 500 to 700 pounds. If you want to rent a garage, because some people do lend them and other people do rent them, you can count on another 120 pounds a month on top of all the costs that you have. But this is just if you feel confident enough to park your bike somewhere which will not be your house very likely. So if you're okay with that, if you're okay in parking in just a random place as long as it has a gate, then you count on another 120 pounds. So after all this, it's up to you to see if you want to get a bike or you don't. Yes, it will be cheaper to use public transportation. Will it be as fun? No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. These things are the best. Try it, give it a go, and see how less stressful your days become. Because after you finish work, the thing that will give you most joy is to grab your little motorcycle and head home, or go for a ride before you even head home. Believe me, it is one of the best feelings that you can get. Except for, but you know, that's not included here. And again, guys, remember, if you have any other themes that you want me to discuss, do you want me to talk about, just give my general opinion, just let me know in the comments below. I'll make sure I'll write it down and make sure I will have it in one of the future motovlogs. Hope you guys enjoyed the video once again. And see ya on my next vlog. Cheerio, matey. Alright guys, there's you know, these things which we cannot resist. Wait, I need to put another one down. I love this so much. It's so nice.